But this is the Gold Championship Series Group D winner bracket semi-final. The winner will face 120 for a slot into the playoffs. The loser will drop down and has to fight for his tournament life against Lucifer later today. The winner bracket final will be tomorrow, and the decision, the loser bracket final, will be tomorrow as well. But this is Foggy's first offline event. This is Foggy's first time playing not from home. This is Foggy's first time to be in a different country than the Ukraine. Of course, there are people taking care of him, and they seem to do a good job. He feels kind of... He feels good, as we heard. Yesterday, he was a bit tired because he didn't sleep on the plane, and he wasn't used to the time zone there in China, but apparently he slept 15 hours, and he seems to be in a great mood today. We saw a few pictures, shaking hands with Lin. We saw him smiling for the cameras, playing with the other players, practicing a bit. So this is basically like the bird who gets thrown out of the nest for the first time. And at the ground, there's a big, big dragon called Lin, the man who has so much experience, the man who played so many offline tournaments, won BlizzCon back-to-back, and oh wow, the Chinese community vote, 95% are rooting for Lin, or betting on Lin, only 5% for the Ukrainian. Europe is watching! Fly, what will he think about this? Does he know about his hippos? That is the big question. Foggy, one of the few guys who prepared a different tactic than Talons versus Orc. And it's with units that are rarely played in one-on-one. I think Foggy is the only one doing so. And here we go. Lin, 29 years old, of course, WCG winner he is, BlizzCon winner, he's won it all. The second most decorated man in Warcraft history, right after Moon. He is a legend, but he's back from the army and he is the Korean champion of WCA since Friday when he beat Lolliot in the finals. So he is prepared versus Night Elf. Is he prepared for the Ukrainian? Is he prepared for Harry Potter? Is he prepared for the magic that we all expect? Lin seems to be super relaxed. Lin thinks, all right, this guy, who is he? I mean, he seems to be a nice guy and he has some skills, apparently. But I beat Lolliot and all the other Night Elves. Is this a problem? Here he is, for the first time in Chinese TV. Andre, 23 years old. His biggest accomplishment is a Jarrah Cup win. What a comparison to this legendary WCG win of Lin in 2011. But he doesn't seem too nervous, I guess. Seems to be very calm. Not too stressed. Maybe it's a little hot in the shirt. Yeah, that could be a problem. With all the lights, he's not used to that. And of course, in the Ukraine, it's always very, very cold. But yeah, that's the first picture of our European pride. Will he make us proud today? Many people doubt it. A lot of people hope it. And the game starts. Good luck from both observer production guys here at NetEase. We have the first map on Ancient Isles. Lin is smiling, Foggy slapping his face like a boxer. And I think the game is not starting for me. Someone crashed. Nope, this does not look too good. I think I'm disconnecting from the game. Or someone else. Yeah, disconnect. So we have to rehost. Play the Eye of the Tiger. You have to play it yourself. Dropped out. And we have Lin again. We will have a rehost in a second. If I play the Eye of the Tiger, then the recording is broken and we can't put it on YouTube, so sorry about that. We had the same problems in Yinchuan at WCA, so it is about NetEase, not about our connection here. We're using What the Fast to reduce the spikes. And Foggy brought his own mousepad. That's very important. Watched if Rich on his first LAN event forgot about that. And that's why he couldn't perform as well as he was used to. But that is long, long ago. WarChief, of course, now used to LAN experience as well. So I'm waiting for the rehost to be invited into this game. And there's the invite. Okay, we should be ready. Okay, waiting for the second OB. Come on, guys. Prepare yourself. Everybody's ready. I hope this works now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we'll go for one last view into the studio. See the first, see the players again. The first map is Ancient Isles. Lynn versus Foggy. After 1 week of hype, this is finally, finally happening. The monster from Korea. We see him here. Lynn is facing Harry Potter from the Ukraine. There you have him, Foggy. Now he seems really nervous. And I have huge spikes in this game. I hope this will be better. Like, unwatchable amount of spikes, but yeah, let's see. So we stick with the Chinese camera at the moment until the in-game control is a little better, or the in-game ping is a little better, and I think it's stabilized now. Is it? Yes, looks like it. Oh, why is this still wrong? Sorry for that. Here we go. The colors are still wrong. I have to fix that, but then we're good to go. No. Lynn is of course playing red, Foggy in the blue trunks. And I have to swap that as well. Oh fuck. So much time to prepare and I just fucked something up. Whatever. Alright, here we go! Finally, we're good to go. Ancient Isles it is! Foggy with his first ever LAN tournament. We all know the story. He was qualified for the WCA Pro Qualifier at Gamescom in Cologne. He beat, who was it? Cash in the game for the qualifier, but then his visa was denied. He put so much energy into the preparation for the Pro Qualifier, but only this one paper was missing for him to join the World Championship in 2015. In 2014, he lost in the qualifier. So he wasn't able to go that. His big dream was shattered. He disappeared from the scene. And then this visa issue happened. And Yaws, his replacement, took the second place. But now he has all in his own hands. Is he performing as we are used to? We'll see about that. Wisp scouting here. Nothing too fancy. Blade Master and a grunt. But the Wisp scouts, of course. Is the Blade Master going for harass or is he creeping? We'll see. Demon Hunter as the first hero. I think he got all the experience here. Yep, no Engine of War kill just yet. And Lynn, of course, trying to go for the claws in the early stages of that game. Demon Hunter's going for the shop already. Foggy is one of the most creative players we have in the entire scene of Warcraft. He plays stuff that no one else does. Hippo Riders, Mass Fury Dragons, crazy second and third heroes. Creep routes, unlike any other, maybe comparable to Law Liot only. Those two are making it happen. And he goes for the harass. He has no staff, but dust to reveal the Blade Master once he, whenever he wants to. Mana burns, so no wind. Okay, that's the final Windwalk. He's getting the backstep, but Foggy with the first accomplishment. Killing the Orc Burrow while it builds, and that keeps Lynn's supply stuck. And that slows down his creeping. So the first little achievement for the Ukrainian here. Tier 2 tech has started, and we see no Huntress Hall just yet. So usually you see a lot of talents for like 10 to 12 years. This is the case now where Night Elves go for the Beastmaster, for the Tinker later, Druids of the Talon, and then Cyclone, Cyclone, Cyclone. All the experts said, or we said, and everyone I talked about this with, Foggy cannot beat Lin with talents. He cannot play his usual. He has to play something out of the box. And we heard Ugrilainen, Lin does not know Foggy. Lin is not aware of the tactics that Foggy can pull out. But he has only one archer. So this is not going to be Hippo Riders. Definitely not. Maybe it's Mass Fury Dragons, but I highly doubt it. Not that effective against the Grunts and Raiders. So, almost level 2 for the Blademaster here. Foggy is level 2 already, getting the boots and getting a staff. He wants to be aggressive. He wants to go into the main base again. Tier 2 is almost finished, and if he goes now, his timing would be perfect. But no, he sees Lin is coming into my base. He wants to cancel the tier 2 producing buildings as well, so I should better head home and defend this. Mana burn immediately, no more backstab, no more windwalk, and I think there's nothing to gain here for Lin. So he will retreat most likely. Tier 2 tech for Foggy is finished. We see the Beastmaster. This seemed to be the normal talent play that everybody said it's not working, but he practiced with Orc Worker every day, day in and day out. And he is perfect here. The perfect timing to cancel the buildings. The Beastry gone would be great. The Lodge gone would be even better. Now the Demon Hunter is joining the fray, providing more damage. And that is a nice accomplishment. Delaying the Raiders, delaying the End Snare. And he gets through the Peons. And he gets through the Spirit Lodge. He has to portal out at some point with the Staff of Tali. But since there's no End Snare and there's no Hex, since he's going for the Tauren Chieftain, this is a great opening for Foggy. He's going for the next Burrow. And that would keep Lund's supply stock forever. He's got it. He has to town portal out. Now, no, there's a Staff of Preservation. That's why he was delaying the push a little bit. He's going... What a push for Foggy. What a push for Foggy. And there's no signs of respect. There's no signs of hesitation. Like, oh my god, this is Lin offline. What, I'm so scared. I'm shaking. No, this is full aggression right from the start. And I love this, but that does not mean that Foggy has the game won already. He bought a lot of time. He bought a lot of time. Tier 2 buildings had to be cancelled. This costs lumber and resources. And yeah, the burrow is gone. He's not setting up a new one. He's not setting up a new one because he was lacking lumber. All the energy that the chat sent to Shanghai seem to be worth it for now. He's stealing the big red spot, and he is rewarded with a Wand of the Wind additional Cyclone for free. That costs a few more dispels for Lin, and dispels are quite expensive for the Orc. So you can't dispel everything you want. You have to be really, really careful with those. Level 2 for both heroes here, and the Tauren Chieftain starting to level up to level 1.5, but only 3 grunts, not 4, and the Blademaster is not level 3 as well, so he will be part of the creeping. That will slow down the entire creeping. Now we have the burrow back. Now Lin can produce again. He's going for the Ensnare upgrade before the first Raider, but we don't see a Walker. We don't see the Adept upgrade just yet because they are just so expensive. Lin still lumber problems, and that is why Foggy is moving out on the map so far. He's going for the second red spot creep for the Warlord that provides decent experience, and of course the big consumable items here. Health Stone would be great. Book of the Dead can be amazing in this situation now. He's getting Anchor Free Incarnation. Never wrong. Staffing out the Beastmaster. Lin catches him here at the creep, but it's gone already. He has the item. He has the experience. Level 2.5 on the Demon Hunter. The talents are coming. Tier 3 tech is finished. He has the Master upgrade lined up. Everything is according to plan for the newbie, if you want to call him that. Of course, he has several Jera Cup wins on his sleeve, but it's all online. Lin is coming back now. Two walkers, the Raiders are coming, and Ensnare is ready. But this was usually the time for the Orcs to shine. The early tier 2, or not the early, the midst of tier 2, once you have Ensnare and Talon Master Training is not finished. Foggy went through the hard times without losing anything. Not even a town portal. He staffed everything back. Good utility of the item that he has. One scout wisp is being killed, and here comes Lynn. Does he have pillage? No, he doesn't. Going for the Moonwells, but there's only one raider, so it's not the biggest of threats. Is the master upgrade done? No. 20 seconds. Here is Wind of the Wind being used on the blade master. Repairs coming in. Shockwave onto the wisp, so the Moonwell is down. He's not supply stuck, though. He's losing one raider, most likely. Nice micro by Lynn. 4 HP left. Cyclone again. The second Wind of the Wind. Is there mana for Windwalk? No. And there's another one. Can we get the surround closed? This seems to be closed. No, he's letting it out because Lynn retreats. Lynn comes back into this fight. Wind of Illusion being used. And here comes Detonate from the Wisps. Use it. He wants to get rid of the mana of the Walkers. But for now, he leaves them alive. The Ancient of War is, of course, helping greatly against the Raiders. So 46 food for Lynn. 34 for Foggy. Only now he's rebuilding the Moonwell. That was the first little opportunity. The first little skirmish that went in favor of Lynn. And he gets the Wisp that wants to get the Tinker. So without Tinker, without Pocket Factory, it's going to be hard for Foggy. But he goes for the next item. This is a thing that also Focus does. Not creeping the entire creep spot, but only going for the items. And this Red Drake can spawn something amazing like Boots of Quel'Thalas, Sui Masks, and it is Rune Braces. Okay, he will sell that. He doesn't need it in this matchup. And Leg. Okay, better now. Let's switch to the stream again since this is. Okay, this is lagging as well. Too bad. We have to live with this for now. I'm trying to get the stream back up. A little refresh here. Oh boy. I hope this will stabilize. Lynn is coming in for the creep jack. Foggy realizes it. Town portal's out immediately. No pickoffs for Lynn. And I think. Ah, damn it. Still some spikes. Okay, let's go for the stream, because the stream is working. And if it stabilizes, we'll switch again to our own control of the game. The sound is a little off, sorry about that. Can I mute this real quick? Yes, I can. So, what did we miss? A bit, actually. This is the restream now, since the in-game is not working properly. Lynn is once again approaching Foggy's main base. And the Torrent Chieftain looks pretty damn good. First, Shockwave is not hitting too much. The Ancient of War is helping and fighting against the Berserker back then, but the Talons are not in a perfect spot. He still does not have a Tinker for the Pocket Factory and for the Clockwork Goblins. That's going to be his problem in this fight. But the Cyclones are used very, very well. Once again, the Torrent Chieftain is high up in the air, as well as the Blade Master. The Talons are in a great position now, but he lacks some damage here. And the Demon Hunter, ooh, he has to be staffed. He wants to fight out. Invo Potion being popped on the Demon. And Lynn is looking so strong here. 37 food for Foggy. Is there another? No, there's no Shockwave for him. Heal scroll being used to get the Talons back up. A shockwave would be horrendous in that position, but he doesn't have one anymore. Good mana burns on the side of Foggy here, and I think it's all calming down a bit. He wants the surround on the Blade Master like in the first fight, but that was an overcommitment. Will this be an overcommitment as well? The Talons are all lined up for the Raiders and a Shockwave, but still, there's no mana on the TC. The Blade Master has to carry this when he is down. Demon Hunter is not in the fight. What's he doing? He's struggling to get items, I guess. And he hides from the Orcish army, and now his Talons are with the back against the trees. Horrible position for him, but he's getting one Raider in return. Lynn sends him away, but I think it died nevertheless. now level up on the Beastmaster, level 2 on the Quill Beast. That's a good damage deal for him. Foggy's still hanging in this fight. 49 food for versus 34, but that's not the biggest of deal. He gets the Torrent Chieftain. He gets him surrounded, but how long will it last? The Beastmaster's instead. The Beastmaster's in trouble. He has to use the town portal, but the moon juice is all gone. He needs a potion. He needs a potion desperately. Nice Cyclone on the TC and mana burn again, but he has level 3.5. He killed a lot of talents, and Foggy is back in his main base. My game is stabilized, so we will have the controls again and in-game sound. So this looks a little better here, right? Level 3.5 on the Demon Hunter. The Tinker is finally here. The Beastmaster as well, level 3, as we mentioned. On the other side, level 3 Blade Master, but he got both Heal Scrolls. Very, very nice and close to level 4. Also the Torrent Chieftain, very close to level 4. And Lynn is at 52 food. But talents are cheap and talents are fast to build. So supply-wise, he will be back. The struggle he has, will he be able to buy the amounts of scrolls and invo potions that he needs? Level 3 Demon Hunter for level 2 mana burn is the perfect answer to the Demon Hunter, obviously, and to the Blade Master. Two heal potions on the Beastie, and he has a scroll and an invo potion. The inventories look nice. The inventories of Foggy look nice, but what will Lin get at the Red Drake? Can Foggy creepjack him here? Vamp Aura would be the dream for Lin. And some other decent items here. Level 4, the Torrent Chieftain, but Link, but Foggy catches him. This build immediately, he wants the Drake to be gone. Nice, Shockwave, but not hitting too much. We have the Devotion Aura, which is not the item that he was looking for. Great position for Foggy here, hiding at the trees. Shadow Priest being used for additional dispel against the Spirit Link. And Foggy is playing this good, not overcommitting to this fight. He hides in the trees, doing some damage, trying to get some dispels out, mana burns out. This is all very patient and calm. But for how long? Lin wants to trick him into a great position. This is a great orc position. Everything is free. But Foggy, not in my house, bitch. I will not fall for this. Blade Master's killing one Talon. Oh, nice crow form being used. 43 food for Foggy now. We have 59 on Lin. And he has no money for a mana potion at the moment, so it's not the biggest of threats. And it's not a level 5 TC, but he's on the way. We saw in the series against Laliet, he prefers to have a level 5 Torrent Chieftain over a level 4 Blade Master. Or a level 5 Blade Master. So the creeping is always for the TC. He's not doing too much with his Blade Master. Fury Dragons are coming as well. A little more sniping here and there, but the Fury position seems to be great. The Shockwave, Foggy tried to dodge it, but it didn't work. And so it's 43 versus 59. The heroes have to carry. The Pocket Factory is in a good position. The Clockworks will do great damage. First Raider is down, but the Tinker using the potion immediately. Dispel, Invo Potion swapped as well. That was needed for something else later. He's going for the Beastmaster. Pure hero focus from Lin here, even though he has the way bigger army, but it's working here. Foggy losing all the items that he has. Wants to go. Wants to have the Torrent Chieftain, but that's it. Beastmaster down. TC stays alive. And this looks kinda bad now, but the right clicks on the demon. Spirit Link saving the TC, but for how long? There is no boots on the Blade Master, and there's the aura that keeps the TC alive here, but there is mana block from the Wisp, and there's the right click. He needs one more! Another block! Great move by Foggy, and the TC has to die, and he dies! Level 4, but what is left of his army? What is left of Foggy's army? 35 food for him, Lin at 53, but the loss of the Torrent Chieftain is a lot worse for Lin than the loss of the Beastmaster is for Foggy. The aura that he provides, plus the damage, the area of effect damage, is way, way more valuable. I'm trying to go for the stream here again. Since in-game is lagging, but we have the option to go for the restream, so you don't miss anything here in this broadcast of Back to Warcraft. Lin has entire map control now. Of course, with an army like that, Foggy always has to go for the exact right positions. He cannot fight an open battlefield. He has to hide somewhere, preferably, of course, in his base. And Lin is coming at it again. Lin... Oh, I have to turn out the sound. Oops. He's going for the altar, and there's no repair. The Beastmaster will not be back in quite some time. Nope, the altar is down, and without Quill Beast, it's gonna be hard. But Lin is fighting without his Terran Chieftain as well. Did not get him back from the tavern. The position for the Talons is quite okay. Pocket Factory is down. Level 5 on the Blade Master, did I saw that correctly? Oh boy. Oh, he gets the Tinker. He catches him off guard. Where the hell was he? He is dead, definitely. Puts him in the death box. A lot of hurt units for Lin. But still, the damage is lacking. No clockworks, no quill beasts, no nothing. The Demon Hunter has to carry. Foggy fighting this like a lion, getting a surround on the raider here. And getting nice pickups here and there. More raiders are dying, but the Demon Hunter has been dragged away. Nice, and Enslaved to save both mercenaries. Lin is playing this really, really good. Nicely done. The staff, the Ensnare wanted to cancel it, but it was too early, I guess. So 33 supply for Foggy. As I mentioned, losing talents is not that big of a deal if you still have gold. And my in-game is stable again, so we go for that. TC is back with a good amount of mana. The Demon Hunter has to take care of that issue. And yeah, it is a level 5 Blade Master, 5.5. That shows you how many units he killed. But the Tinker is back and the Beastmaster is back as well. So he has the damage that he lacked before in the fight. Lin up at 49. He's not going into upkeep anymore. Pillage is coming. How far along are the gold mines? 650 here, 600 here. The longer the game goes, the better it is for Foggy. You can move up your Tree of Eternity, walk it to the natural expansion, but Lin does not want that to happen. He's fighting again. This time the position for Foggy is horrible. Maybe he can fight in this choke, so it would be a little better. The shockwave goes into nowhere. Second bad shockwave from him that I've seen. Tinker has a problem. Where's the Pocket Factory? Doesn't have the mana. And Snare on the Demon Hunter. He has an Invo Potion and a Heal Scroll. So maybe that will help. Oops, what the hell? Sorry about that. The Tinker is dead, but the Beastmaster is still alive. The Tinker is just food for the army to prevent damage from other where. And the Demon, can he escape here? Oh, looking horrible. There's no Moon Juice left and he's down. Double Cyclone, but Foggy's numbers are falling apart here. Well played, he says. And Foggy loses the first map after 20 minutes, but he put up a good fight. Especially the early game was very, very nice. Let's see the reactions of the players. Lin still looking chilled. He's sweating a bit, but still. Does he think, alright, this guy is better than expected? So don't underestimate him? Could be the case. I show him again and now go back. Okay, back and forth and back and forth. But Foggy is not chanceless. And he saw that as well. I don't really know what made the big difference. There should have been like one fight that Foggy took where he overextended, where he wanted to surround the Blade Master, and that failed. Okay, we see it again here. The harass in the early game was absolutely picture perfect. Diving in with the Demon Hunter, canceling both tier 2 buildings and the Orc Burrow. So he survived the early stages of tier 2, he survived the second stages of tier 2, he got into tier 3 very, very early, very early and without any pressure, but he couldn't really get the job done afterwards because the timing of Lin was still great. And yeah, that was it. He tried to go for the surround, but he saw the army coming, and that's where he lost a lot. Next map is Amazonia. Lin always found a good position to fight in. It didn't look great from the start in those fights, but I think the Pocket Factory was never in a great place. And yeah, he lost the heroes. Lin heavily going for hero focuses. Foggy did a lot good things, but this fight was not one of it. Well, actually the start of this fight. And he had the Tinker very, very late. So I think that that first fight without the Tinker was in the end what broke his back. Because he never really recovered from that. So the favorite is leading 1-0. Will we see the special tactics now? The block was amazing, yes. But in the end it was just too much. With Berserkers you had a good amount of damage. The Blade Master was very, very high leveled. Because Foggy kept on feeding a bit. But this game could have turned the other way around. Definitely. It's not a shaky performance, it's not a disappointing performance like Vyla, like Life. He's up there with the goods, with the best, with the legends. Okay, I think it's about to start. Just waiting for a countdown here. Much hype here when Lind TC died. Okay. ...1,800 viewers here watching Foggy perform good in the GCS so far. We have a new donation, by the way. $8 by LionKing102. Wow, I'm so ready for this match. Will be epic. Thank you so much, Neo, for your awesome streams. I love watching Warcraft like in the old times. So much fun this week in my holidays. Thanks for that and greetings from Germany. Thank you very much, Lion King. Very, very nice comment and very nice words from you. Thanks a lot. So Foggy took out his hoodie. Maybe it was too warm with all the camera lights. You cannot really expect that. Well, you can't expect that, but maybe you think it's hotter. It's not as hot as you think it is. And now we're going in-game once again. More than 5,000 viewers here on all streams combined. This is map number 2. Lin has a 1-0 advantage. Got it on Ancient Isles. What will Foggy put up now? Special tactics or not? We've been talking about this a lot. And I think if he wants to have a chance to the playoffs, he has to beat Lin. Because facing 120 against Night Elf is not that easy, guys. So I think, as crazy as it sounds, Lin might be the more easy opponent than 120 is, but you have to beat them both to advance, so, or at least one of them. And Lucifer before that, so it's gonna be a rocky road, it's gonna be a long road, and it continues here on AZ. Lin in the bottom left, he is a legend. He is so calm, he is so cool. But he saw that this game was a 50-50 game. And maybe there is some respect for the Ukrainian. Oftentimes, the European scene is belittled, by Koreans and especially the Chinese. Yumiko knows it better. A lot of Koreans know it better as well. Focus, Lawlight, all of them. But Moon and Lin, I don't know. They still have the old habits that Europe, except from Grubby and some other guys, Todd, Deadman, all those. Europe is not that strong. But Foggy can show them that we are. He's been practicing so much. He has entire folders of creep routes. He has folders of where to position your Wisp. The build orders that he has are shared at Reddit at the moment, by the way. So if you're a Night Elf, go and download them and learn from Froggy. Very entertaining streams as well. This guy is so dedicated to Warcraft. It's just a blessing to see him here in his first big tournament. Lin starting this creep as usual at the laboratory. Gloves of Haste, that's alright. Level 2 on the Demon Hunter. Circlet and Cloak of Shadows. Tier 2 tech immediately. So, yeah, will he try to go Talons again? There's a lot of good fighting opportunities for Lin on this map. But if you can hide, like, to the tavern or with some trees or in your base, you can still pull it off. Once again, Foggy is going for this harass, Lin trying to block, but this Orc Burrow will die as well. And Lin keeps on being supply stuck, just as in game one. There's no reaction to that. And if you remember, when Focus came back, this was also the thing that he was struggling with. The tier 2 aggressiveness from the Night Elf. It's not coming with the Beastmaster, it's coming earlier. And sometimes the Beastmaster has been used for creeping, but now the base is blocked. Foggy is trapped inside the base of Lin, but he uses the Cloak of Shadows and it just turned night. So he has quite some time to stay in there and keep the Demon Hunt, the Blade Master from leveling. Oh, he's in Windwalk! Foggy expects him to be gone! Backstep! And he does not get the burrow. But he kept him stuck, only one grunt on the field, so creeping for Lin is not a good option at the moment. And it takes more time. You can't do crazy creep spots now, like here the Merc Camp or whatever you want to do, no. Foggy's going for the staff most likely, selling the cloak and getting boots and Demon Hunter and the staff. Sharp is coming, of course, no Huntress Hall. But once again, only one archer if I saw that correctly, so it is Talons again. Blademaster finds his level 2 and the Slippers of Agility. Nice boost, plus 5 damage and increased attack speed for him with that. The Ancient of War is moving forward, by the way, most likely for that creep spot. But Foggy is not going for the aggressive this time, not with his Beastmaster. He scouts this grunt, he knows the Blademaster must be close by. Oh, he's going for that. He's not going for the creep. He cancelled his plans. The Engine of War was too slow. And now he's going for it. What's his timing? Once again, the timing seems to be amazing. He can squeeze through with the Quill Beast. He's going for the Beastery. The Grunt is not blocking anymore. So this is map number one all over again. Beastery. This time, yeah, he staffs in! Well done by Foggy, and immediately he cancels the tier 2. Beastmaster's keeping himself safe. Going for the burrows again. No, going for the grunt with two Quillbees. That can work. Wow. Oh, I thought Lin got the block here. Yeah, now he got it. Very well done. Protecting his hurt grunt with a healthy one. And not going for the burrows, is that the correct call? I think it is. He could get both. He could get both. It was a nice move of Lin at first, but now it's not working anymore. The Blademaster is arriving too late, and Foggy is getting two grunts here at the start of this game. This is even better than the start on Ancient Isles. It's blocked. He has no dust. He has no dust. He's blocked in his own main base. He can't get out. A genius strike. Shades of Lawlight. Shades of Lawlight. He did the same to Shishi in the NWL. And this What can you do? He cannot creep. He can't do anything until it turns day. He has time for the buildings now, but he can always step in with the demon. Now Windwalk. He has enough mana for Windwalk. Okay, I forgot about that. But the demon hunter can step in. He's using it to creep at the moment, but I can see double trouble again. Does he notice it? Does he seize the opportunity? The time is running short now. And I think he's not stepping in. Might be a wasted chance for Foggy. Maybe he's not thinking about it. Maybe he thinks it's too risky. Okay, now that the Grunt is there, I think he can't enter anymore. So he's using the time to creep again. Stealing spots from Lin, he is. Almost level 3 on the demon. And, of course, a completely under-leveled and under-equipped Blade Master. This is level 3, level 2 mana burn. And the Hawk is not far away. Will this be level 2 for the Beastie? Yes, already. Lin is trying to steal. And he got it. He got it with the Grunt. The genius of Lin coming out now. He is not only one of the best of all times, but he's also the Korean champion. In the first tournament after his comeback, he beat Law Liot, Focus, Reprisal, Moon, everybody. Oh, okay, not Moon, actually. Moon beat him. But apart from that, it was a marvelous performance in the Korean qualifier for the World Championships. Heal scroll for Foggy. Staff, Invul Potion, he has all he needs. Lin, creeping this spot, looking for a Vamp Aura, but it is True Shot. 10% increased damage on the Walkers and the Berserker. That is kind of nice. But not perfect. 32 food for Foggy. He is producing talents like crazy, but Lin, of course, wants to keep the count low. Foggy is not allowed to fight here. Nope. Level 2 on the TC. Still not that threatening. It's not level 3, but he needs more talents. He needs more time. He's investing so much into items that he can't get a big army up. Lin already up at 46. But there's no dispel just yet. Purifier on this Grunt, so Foggy sees where Lin is moving. But this is a passive creeping, very, very calm creeping, very safe creeping. He needs at least 40 food. This time he has the Tinker very early. So he can, maybe can take a fight now with 40 food. Yes, he can. The rule of thumb is 10 food advantage for the Night Elf, for the Orc, and then he can fight. At the moment, it's not looking like he can do it. But of course, a lot of open space, especially here at this position at Amazonia. Foggy wants to take his natural expansion, but Lin will not allow this. Lin is playing this very, very smart, not overcommitting. Is Foggy overcommitting now? 47 versus 49. He just scared him away from the rat spot. But it looks like he wants to fight. Looks like he wants to fight. Late Master scouting everything. But there is Fury Fire on him, so Foggy knows. And the Hawk. Torn Chieftain has no mana potion at the moment. Retreating a bit, getting the Murloc spot done. It's not level 3 for him afterwards. Just a tiny bit of experience. Battle for the heal scrolls, and the Demon Hunter got it. The Demon Hunter got one. Two heal scrolls now. One Invul potion. No heal potions though. On this side, one Invul potion and one heal scroll. Slight advantage for Foggy in all regards. How much longer since... Ah, okay. Lin will get another heal scroll if Foggy is not chasing him away. It's available now. And he got it. And the invul potion, oh, he leaves it in. Does not want to go for that invul to not be mana burned. Full mana on the TC. Empty mana on the Blade Master, though. Both players standing toe-to-toe. Ready to exchange blows. Foggy has the Engine of War here. It looks like a great position for the Ukrainian. Can he capitalize from that position? The shockwave was not good. Definitely not. Mana burn on the TC and he is empty. No mana potion for him. He has not to be threatened of a level 2 wave at the moment. He scares the raiders away. They're trying to find the right angle. And now they do. Pocket Factory stays alive for a long time. So we saw a lot of Clockwork Goblins. First raider down. 45 versus 49. Dispels everywhere. The second raider is going down. This looks good. This looks really good for Foggy. The Fury Dragon is in time. And he has a great position, or had a great position from the start. Lin is switching to hero. Folks, he goes for the Ant Snares, goes for the Demon, but the round on the TC! He has to be careful with his Demon, though. Invul Potion being popped, there is something on the TC that is a Heal Scroll, uses it right now. Oh boy, can he escape? The surround is not closed anymore. Speed Scroll saves him, and Ant Snare on the Demon. But the TC has to be so careful. Not getting this Walker healing immediately. But the Talons, they're coming for him. Level 3 on the Beastmaster. Foggy is wiping the floor with Lin, as it seems. But Lin saved a lot of units. Another surround on the TC. And that has to be it. Second hero down. Level up on the Tinker. Level 3. He killed so much. And now it's time to kill all the hurt units here. He's going for the Blademaster. One more Windwalk. And that's about it. Oh, but Lin, is he coming back into this fight? The Talons are exposed to the Raiders. He sends them all back in. The Demon Hunter is not doing that great damage against this Berserker now here. Cluster Rockets from the Tinker as well. Everything is slowed and stunned for a second. But Lin, I don't know, man. He saved so many units that are all coming back into the fight now. Foggy has to do more last hits. Level 4 on the Blademaster. Critical strike immediately. There is another heal scroll. And did he swap something? No, but there's the staff. Saving the second hero who can come back very, very quick. The Tinker is almost untouched. But now he's exposed. Demon Hunter is exposed. Cyclone being used. Damage mitigated because the Blademaster is not in the fight anymore. And Lin is heavily committing to this first hero kill. Can he get out again? He escaped once. There is no staff. There's the potion. He could swap it. The Beastmaster has it. Level 4, level 2 evasion. Will this do a good job? Lin is losing his entire army committing to this first hero. And all of a sudden, it's 41 food for Foggy and 34 for Lin. He has lumber problems. He's getting the last hits on the peons. And this looks like a GG. At the moment, yeah, there is nothing anymore to save the Blademaster. He has him surrounded. And Foggy, what can Lin do here? He cannot escape anymore. First hero is down and Lin succeeds. Lin taps out here. Foggy with the map win against the Korean Monster Orc with a flawless performance. You see the reaction. The Becker fist is out. And does he turn on beast mode now? Amazonia is not the best map to play as an orc because you have struggles getting your second hero up to level 3. We saw the struggle here. He only had one shockwave and then came the mana burn and the TC was completely empty on mana. That was, once again, great timing for Foggy to go into the base. This Blademaster block with the archer was genius. And if someone in Korea and China did not know Foggy, they do now. Let's recap this game a bit. The creep right from the start. Chinese seem to be impressed with it. This came up by Law Light and Foggy is using it to perfection. It looked like the Demon Hunter was almost gone and had to staff out, but no, not this time. The Cloak of Shadows kept him alive. This harass was once again great. I thought he would do a mistake by not stepping in for the second time. But who am I to argue Foggy? Getting two grunts here. Marvelous. Marvelous. It's completely spiraled out of control for Lin. And there he was trapped. Had to wait for the next Windwalk to get out of there. Amazing performance. And almost 2,000 viewers are watching this at the moment. imagine him beating him. And I told you that Foggy was able to do it. But it's just one map. It's 1-1. They're standing toe-to-toe. The game starts... is about to start. Oops, the stream is gone. But I think it will stabilize in a second. Yes, there it is back again. So you see the... Come on! I want to see the death of the TC again. There he is. Lin heavily committing to a hero kill, of course. It was the one thing that could have got him back into this game. But Foggy had all the tricks, all the stabs, all the right item swaps here. And without mana, the Blade Master can get out of this round. GG by Lin. Every critic that said Foggy is just gonna get wrecked, he will be too nervous, he's not that good, you're all proven wrong. At least for now. Final map is Echo Isles. We saw it already in the Undead Mirror 120 versus Lucifer. The favorite prevailed there and saw 120 advancing to the winner bracket. The winner of this upcoming map will face 120 in the winner bracket final. The loser has to play Lucifer in the winner bracket semi-final for his tournament life. And the game starts. The game starts. And no bug. Nope. Everything went flawlessly. At least for us. Here we see the players again. Foggy. Drying his hands. Maybe he's sweaty. He's hitting himself again. And he's good to go. Lin is not that relaxed anymore. Not that chilled anymore. He received a beating on the second map. And guys, game number 3. This is already better than 90% of the community expected it to be for Foggy. Gold Championship Series continues. And before we go into this game, we have another donation by Gosu Gohan. $10. Thanks for all the efforts this week. Can't wait to see the matches I missed on YouTube. Thank you very much for the support, man. Highly appreciated. But now, enough with the donations, enough with the subscriptions. This is pure Warcraft now. In the upper left, coming from Lviv, Ukraine, 23 years old. He is Foggy, and he looked so strong. But of course, Amazonia, a map maybe Lin not that familiar with at the moment. At least not as familiar as he is with Echo Isles. He's been around for more than 10 years. Of course, 2-year break when he was in the army. But he's stronger, maybe stronger than ever. He dominated the scene from 2007 to 10, I would say. Especially 2009 was one of the best years a pro gamer had ever seen in the Warcraft scene. But that's 7 years ago. His comeback was almost flawless in the WCA APEC qualifier. But now there's a little guy coming from the Ukraine. Demon Hunter, Blade Master, obvious heroes. So we have to mention this. On Echo Isles, there's only one shop. And versus a Blade Master, it's very, very hard to keep the so important shop control. You want the heal scrolls, you want the invul potions, so you have to keep tabs on that. Always show your map presence there in the region of the shop. And that's the one special thing about Echo Isles. Of course, here's also the marketplace. Both races can go for the Magi with the hero alone. Watch if Rich likes to do it with an archer positioned here and the Demon Hunter sneaking in here, killing it, and of course the Blade Master creep. I think I don't have to explain that. That's been known for years. Foggy is being aggressive right from the start. Again, he's not finishing this creep spot with his hero, only with the archer and the Ancient of War. But Lin, this time around, not going for a creep either. Circlet of Nobility as a first drop for him, that is great. The Grunt scouts this, and this might be a last hit. No, not a last hit from the Blade Master, but he has to be careful with the Archer not losing too much units here. hidden Moonwell, by the way. Nice. He expected this little go from Lin, and he hides his Moonwell right away. Question is, can he keep the archer alive, or does he have to face this with a demon hunter alone? Foggy is definitely will be surprised if this is one last Moonwell that he would love to have, and now he finds the Moonwell. That could be horrendous for the Ukrainian. Lin is returning the favor of the early aggression. Will it be enough? I don't think so. It's gonna be dicey, but if he can get the grunt... Speed Scroll being used. Well done by Lin. He sends him away. Little mistake. But in the end, he prevails. And that is what makes him so strong, especially on game number one. Sending back all the hurt units and healing them up with Heal Wave instead of reproducing them. Sorry for the spikes, but yeah, we are connected to a game in China. That is not the best routing. And he's getting the Moonwell again. Lin's early game a lot better this time here on Echo. Shop in the middle of the map. He wants to go for the Beastie push right away. Will this succeed? The tech almost done. For Lin, he's slightly behind, but no pressure this time in the early stages of this game. Battle for the boots, the staff for the Blade Master, and he denies Foggy the opportunity for that big tier 2 push this time with his one move. He has the boots though, which is nice, but the pressure continues, staffing onto the ground, not home obviously, and going for the Wisp Hunt now. Ay. So far, Foggy has been outclassed on map 3. It's only the Demon Hunter. Constant presence of the Orc. Zero time to do something, but this will release the headlock a bit. This will give Foggy some time. The go with the Beastmaster. It's not supported by the Demon Hunter this time, but he had to cancel this Moonwell again. And this might be dying. Oh boy. This is horrible, but how much damage can he do in return? That's the big question. The Moonwell is gone and Foggy is supply stuck again. The pressure of Lin seems to be too high. He can't do that much. The repair is in time. And he's attacking the next Moonwell. He has to kill them all, I feel. But it's not looking too good. The Beastmaster took a beating already. Down to 50%. The repair is enough. But now with 3 Quill Beasts, he has to do it. He has to cancel at least one. And he gets it. But the Blade Master and the Grunts, they feel like home here in the Night Elf base. They absolutely feel like home. He's setting up the next Moonwell once again in the same spot. Of course you want to block. Oh boy! That was risky. And there's no Moondruth at the moment. He's going for the base. It is a base raise by now. But with only the Demon Hunter, he can't kill the second Burrow. And the Torrent Chieftain is taken care as well. Free repair here on the Entangled Gold Mine. This seems to be working. But for how long is the question? Foggy is heavily struggling. Heavily struggling. Demon Hunter has to get back now. The Moonjuice. At least he gets one of the Moonwells back up. Second one is about to finish. Where is the Beastmaster? Still low. Isn't there mana? There is. Oh, no mana on the Blade Master here. But the lores get cancelled. Beastmaster gets the healing finally. Demon Hunter is back, but the Moon Juice is gone. I don't see Foggy coming back from this. Lin adapted with the positioning of the building so they couldn't be cancelled this time. It's looking pitch black. I don't know how to deal with it. He needs the Moonwell. There's no repair coming at all. And he loses the Moonwell again and he cannot get his talents. He cannot get his talents. The heroes are low now, but there must be a Moonwell back there. Oh, it's only 34. It's daytime. He has no regen. He's blocking on the TC, but he chooses a different route. And the shop is going to go down. He needs the potion so bad. He has gold because he can't invest anything into units now. But the Quill Beasts are providing at least decent damage. But the Demon Hunter... Whoa, dancing on a knife's edge. He's waiting for that Moonwell to finish, but it's gonna take some time. If Foggy turns this game around, I don't know what I do. Declare me crazy, but Moonstone. Moonstone is so important. Demon Hunter is back to almost full HP. The Torrent Chieftain has no... there is a staff with the Quillbeast. Can he get him? Oh, he has to cancel him! And the TC is dead! He underestimated the damage from the Quillbeast, and now it's time to get the Blade Master. There is no mana, and mind you, there is boots on the Demon Hunter, not on the Blade Master. This was an opportunity that Foggy wanted to have. Finally some time to get his units out. He will get a few hits. Is something coming? Ah, the Ant's Narrator saves him. Lin has his tier 2. So finally, the chase is over. The hunt is over. Tier 3 by Foggy now. We see another Engine of Wind, but once again, no repair on this Moonwell. He's not protecting it at all. Double heal potions now. And I thought being with the TC gone, with the Blade Master chased home, this would be an opportunity, but the Raiders and the Grunts kill every single building. At least Foggy has some talents now. The repair seems to be too late. He's trying his best, but no. And that is a lot of wasted resources. Lin's so dominant. Has shop control now. The TC is back as well. Only level 1. And we're waiting for tier 3 of the Night Elf. With the orb, things get a little easier, but he's facing Invu Potion, Heal Scroll, and now he has no shop anymore, at least not here. There is one in his base. Of course, Foggy tries his best to stay alive. The Engine of War, with the Engine of War and some talents, he can hold it to a degree. For Lin, it would be a nice opportunity maybe to expand even on this because of all the pressure. It will take forever for Foggy to get an army. He's at 19 food. And I don't think this Moonwell will come up. I really don't think so. Raiders! And you know what Raiders are doing to buildings. 3 of them are here now. Only 1 Talon. He has to fight this with the heroes alone and some trees. Is he getting the Blade Master here? He's blocking himself, but he wants this Beastmaster so bad! 9. Nice control by Lin once again. He was once one of the best Blade Master players in the world, and he is again as well. Only with Fly beating him in that regard. And now the Engine of War is gone. The floodgates might have opened. Foggy is still supply blocked. Blade Master is portaling home. Get some healing. Get some mana. But it's 49 food knocking on the Ukrainian door. Ay. It's tier 3. Demon Hunter has the orb now. That is good damage over time. But he can't kill everything alone. And Lin's micro is just so good. It's easier, of course, with that Spirit Link. But Foggy cannot afford to lose more Wisps. The production of Lin has stopped, but he's getting ready for 60 food. Foggy is defending this tremendously. A player's forces are under attack. But for how long? End snare! Another end snare! He will be surrounded after this! There's the town hall, he uses it now. But his moon juice is so low! Finally he gets some more moonwells up. But it's all gone, the juice is all gone. And because he has to position the Moonwell so defensively, there's not too much space for the units then. Lin is stealing all the creep spots. The big one. Claws plus 9. Claws plus 9. For the Blade Master, the perfect item. Some spikes here. He's going for the Berserker. 58 food. Production has started again. And he calls peons. Lin wants to end this now. Nail to the coffin. And the army is still so small. The army is still so small. And it's only a level 2 Demon Hunter. He's going for him. The Raiders take care of the production building. And the heroes take care of the heroes. Beastmaster is exposed right next to the Tree of Eternity. Why is he not hitting something? I don't know. Something is blocked. Foggy's trying to go for a hero kill, but there is a heal scroll, there's an invo potion, and the second production building is gone. Lin is killing everything, he puts it to shreds. Now going for the first hero, invo, heal potion is there, Steph, but it's not enough. First hero dies with a potion. GG, well played. Lin versus 120 in the finals, of the in the winner bracket finals. Foggy will play Lucifer in the winner bracket final right here. Right now, at, as the next game. Echo Isles, Lin had the perfect answer. Lin just found the perfect answer. He knew, okay, there is trouble coming. He will go for my tier 2 building, so I will not allow him the time to go for my buildings. And I think there was a handshake, but the camera not too interested in fair play, as it seems. And yeah, Lin, pro as he is, adapted so quick. And completely outplayed Foggy at, on map 3. But there is hope. We have the proof that Lin can be beaten by Night Elves. We have the proof that Lin can be beaten by Foggy. And yeah, now the struggle for Foggy continues. We will have Lucifer versus Foggy coming up. The tournament live for both on the line. This was kinda what everybody expected, but taking a map from Lin is a great accomplishment. So let's see if we get a highlight reel or some reactions. Wait, I got a message from Ugri, I guess. Yes. Okay, I will call Ugri Linen since we don't have a highlight reel. And let's see what our Frenchman in China can report. There is a break in China, so no highlight reel. We'll go for Ugri. And there he is. Ugri, how is the atmosphere right now in Shanghai?
Well, I'm disappointed, but the atmosphere is good. I was like, wait a minute, I forgot my 4G.
What?
1 second.
Oh, okay.
I know, because, yeah, if I start to go outside and I don't have my 4G, it's going to disconnect.
Okay.
we watched the game with, there was Zhu Shishi and Alice and Xiao Kai and... some admins, like the lady that was helping Foggy, so... And 122, so yeah, like it was not like the other game, like when 120 and Lucifer was playing, like some people watch, but like maybe they thought like 120 is going to win or something, that even was not very focused on the game. And when it started to be the second game of playing against Foggy, like everybody stopped playing or laddering or whatever they were doing, okay. And everybody started to watch, like, you know, like it. Sometimes it reminds me of the, you know, the White House picture when there is the red on Ben Laden house, like we see.
Yeah.
sometimes it looks like that. Like everybody's watching and very tense. Yeah, but I feel like people were rooting for Foggy, like after in the second game, like it was such a great game. The third game, it looked very, very, very fast, hopeless, and it's like we all felt that it would be a 2-1 falling right after the start. Like so much pressure from him all the time. Like before, it was more Foggy putting pressure, but this time Lin, like maybe thought, okay, now it's time to go at my top and really. I don't know.
Yeah, I think he wanted to return the favor, and he immediately figured out that if Lin is doing pressure, then Foggy can't do it. So it's just great how Lin is adapting on the fly.
Yeah, but what I think also is that for Foggy still, he won a game. So it's not like he's 2-0 and he's really close. Well, not really close, but I mean like he swapped in like 20 minutes and 2 games.
Yeah,
he did a very good game. And the second game, The first thing was, he was good as well. So I mean, he can give him confidence to beat Lucifer now, because he knows that he can beat the probably one of the best player in history. He can beat him on stage. So I think it's good experience, and now he has to beat Lucifer to get another chance. So
yeah.
I don't know how it's gonna go with Lucifer. Lucifer, we didn't see him back at all.
Okay.
I don't know where he is. Maybe he stayed in the gaming building. So I don't know where he is. Maybe he stayed there because he lost, so he knew he had to play over. I don't know where he is. But 120, he came back, I think, with his girlfriend, as far as I understand.
Okay.
So she speaks English, so we talk a little bit. So I think I will be able to get some comment from 120 later in the day.
Nice.
The fact is that now he has been called to go and play RPG game.
Yeah.
So he's gone back to the studio to play this RPG game. Do you mind if maybe Chatwin wanted to talk to people in Europe? You know, Chatwin is Yumiko's friend. He's gonna say a few words.
Of course.
Give me a second.
Oh my God.
Hey, hi, Chatwin.
Hi.
Listen to it.
Yeah. Okay, you listen to it. Okay,
all right, let's go.
Neil, hi, how are you?
Hi, I'm great. How are you?
Hi. Yeah, I'm so excited, you know, because, you know, I'm talking to my idol.
Aww.
To the Back to Rock FC guy. So you are just like, yeah, amazing. So by the way, I want to say a big shout out to your friends, which, like, you know, 10,000 subscriber.
Yeah,
and
thanks.
To those like 1,400 viewers. Woo. So you guys are amazing. So thank you for making Warcraft 3 live again in Europe. So here, basically, you know, Julian is like Yugui Julian, you know, he's
yeah.
professional. He's extraordinary. He's taking the picture, taking the video, and by the way, he's also taking the, you know, Back to Warcraft 3 video
yeah.
of Yumiko and the WFEZ for the Back to Warcraft 3 channel.
Nice.
So it is amazing. Yeah, it is amazing.
But I think you're a great help for him.
Yeah, it wouldn't be possible without him. So yeah,
it's I'm flattered. I got a dream one day, you know. I have a dream one day that I will be able to talk in the Back to Warcraft 3 channel. And now my dreams come true.
That's so nice. And we're all smiling here, I guess. Oh, it's so great to hear.
I don't know if we have time for an anecdote, but it was funny because we share the same room in the hotel. And at one point, he was sleeping on the bed. And my sister-in-law called. It's a long time I didn't talk to her. And she said, "Where are you?" I said, "At the hotel." And then, "Why?" "Because my wife kicked me out." "Really? And who is sleeping on the bed?" I say, "It's my boyfriend. I'm gay now." "What?" that's why she kicked me out. And it, I was, she was like, "All coffee, come on. What was happening? It's 7 a.m. now."
Yeah, you know, no wonder why I wake up in the morning. Why I woke up in the morning, I feel, you know, my ass feel a little bit painful. So, oh, you got the reason. Oh, I got the visa. Holy crap.
Okay. Not too much detail, maybe. It's
yeah, joke. Yeah. Not too much detail, you know. No repay.
It's great to hear that you have such a great time together, guys. I would love to be with you. Maybe next Gold series. Yeah. I will be with you.
I hope you guys enjoy this joke. And by the way, if Raphael, my Swiss friend, is watching, so I just want to say hi to my friend Raphael. Yeah. Raphael, the Sweden guy.
Yeah, we all know him, I guess. Okay, shout out to Raphael, as well.
Okay, so I will give this back to Julian.
Okay.
So really appreciate it. So for your health in Europe. So you guys are really, really important. You guys are savior to work out in Europe.
Oh, thank you so much, Chatwin. Keep up the good work with Ugri together.
I want to say that I didn't pay him anything to say that. I didn't know what he was going to say. I was a little afraid, but that's fine. Okay, so maybe, I don't know. Now I don't know what we're going to do. Waiting for Foggy to play against Lucifer. I don't know when it's going to be. I'm going to ask. Do you know when?
No idea, but I think with the RPG game, I don't know how long it's going to last. But we have definitely a break of minimum 30 minutes.
Yeah, I'm going to try to find information. And I don't know if I'm going to go to the gaming building or maybe I leave Foggy alone to prepare. I don't know. Each time I want to talk to him, he says, "Okay, no problem." So maybe now he needs to focus. I'm not sure. But Yeah, it's a great day. It's much well, yesterday was great as well, but you know, the atmosphere in the gaming room is better today for me to work, because there is not the 2v2, you know, the Molly gaming, because they were training in the practicing room, so they were taking a lot of space, and so I couldn't really have a good seat and good access to players, because it was crowded. And today there is no 2v2 game, so there is more room, so I can have a full spot, and it's easier to talk to players because they don't really play or train for something. So, because those guys, they don't train like Lin, you know, I insist, like, he's like, I mean, he's like the most cool guy ever. Like, he doesn't, it's like it's everyday's business for him. It's like a day, I mean, I don't know, he enjoys. We talk about Warcraft 3 and compared to Starcraft 2 with him, and he said that. He liked Warcraft 3 better because Starcraft 2, he played it during the army a lot, but he said it's more, you play like a machine, he said, like you have to put, I never played Starcraft 2, so I cannot really explain, but he said like you have to make a lot of groups very early, and it's not the same, it's not as, the strategy is not as interesting as in Warcraft 3, and so he was very happy that to see that the scene was coming back to life when he came back from the army. And so he's very happy, and he plays, and he wins already. We cannot understand how, but I mean, maybe it's a genius. Like, but that's just the only reason I see. Like, he has such a capability to adapt to anything. He doesn't train a specific stuff or a specific event. He just trusts his instinct, I guess, and he's successful like that. Like, it's very impressive. And so I don't know if people saw the tweet about the snoring problem of Lucifer. Yeah. Like, it was so funny. Like, he said, oh, I didn't sleep well. Oh, yeah, I guess because of the trip from Beijing. Yeah, but mostly because, you know, Lucifer is snoring a lot. And and I couldn't sleep well. I was like, yeah, really? And I asked Lucifer about, you know, you told me to ask about his friends Ghostop and Susiri. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and another one, Soccer, maybe. So Soccer, he doesn't know anything about it. What happened to him, he doesn't know. And the other two... he get in touch with them, like he still talk to them, but they stop Warcraft 3 completely. And and one of them had is married with a kid. It's the second, I think, it's Susiria.
Like, yeah, I think so. I heard the rumors about that.
I don't know. I don't do rumors. I'm not a paparazzi. I don't know.
just like, facts from Ugri.
No. Because I learned a lot of rumors about. Who likes who? Who hates who? Yeah. Who is not happy with who? But why? For which reason? And blah blah blah. Girlfriend of this, girlfriend of that. But I'm not going to talk about it now.
I was just about to ask if there's something new in the Yumiko and TH situation.
Oh well, for me, I couldn't talk to TH really because he was casting with Sherlin, yeah. So I took a picture with him. He was nice, took a picture and stuff. But after, I didn't see him anymore. For Yumiko, he's like telling me, why everybody says that? Well, what everybody talk about? I don't like TH and TH don't like me. I said, I don't know. Everybody knows. And he said, I don't hate him at all. he's like saying. It's more like maybe a misunderstanding, and maybe TH, you think maybe TH hates him or whatever, but I don't think there is I think it's easy to fix. So I told him, maybe we just take a picture of you two shaking hands, we send it to Neo, and then nobody says that you fight anymore. So I still need to work on that. I don't think it's gonna be easy to do, but I think it's something that could be done.
All right, sounds good, man. You bring people together there.
Yeah, you know, it's community management from FFA that comes back to life. Like, I mean, come on, why don't you like each other, man? It's useless, like it's stupid reason. So yeah, maybe we're gonna work something out. I don't know. Yeah. And I talked to them about FFA. Well, I want to make my shout out to FFA players because you know, like, I have to admit, like, before 2 months ago, and when I came back, I didn't know anything about the solo scene. Most nothing, like, and when I had to prepare today, it's like thank you Warfare Arena news team and yourself and High Tech and everybody supporting me, because I do all the report, but I get help from Mr. White and ISM and you to give me like yesterday when I went with Yumiko, he came to my room to do the live stream interview. Say, oh, let's do an interview. It was like midnight, or after midnight. I mean, I was like completely wasted because I had the trip, and so okay, let's do an interview. And he said, let's do it live. There's gonna be 5,000 people. I was like, okay. Like, I'm not used to be.
Yeah, I'm still downloading that interview. Like, this will be at Back to Warcraft.
And so, all right. And what was crazy for me is like, I didn't expect to do an interview with Yumiko. So I had all my preparation for everybody else but Yumiko. And I was like, oh my God, I need good question for Yumiko. I'm going to be live with 5,000 people. and I sent messages like, give me question. and so I got like tons of good questions to ask. I had some I wanted to ask, like him and WFZ and so forth, but I didn't have much content with his history and so forth. So then I could go do a good interview. It lasted like 1 hour or something. And Yumiko, he was really interesting. He said a lot of things about the game, about I really need to review my all my notes and the video, but yes, so he was very satisfied with the video, and I spent most of my time with him, with Chatwin and WFZ. We eat together, and we talk a lot about the sponsoring in China, about how it works and the difference it makes between players, and many, but he has very, very good point of view on many important topics, so it was a very interesting thing to do. And,
okay. I can't wait to hear the interview, and I can't wait to read your interviews later at w3arena.net. I think we're going into a little break here. Nothing is happening on the stream
right
at the moment. You can cheer Foggy up a little and prepare him for his game against Lucifer.
Okay.
Okay, thank you then, very much, Ugri.
Thank you, and thank you everybody for listening. Bye-bye.
All right, bye.
See you later. Bye.
Julian, from Shanghai in the NetEase office or studio or whatever it is. So, Foggy versus Lucifer will happen at some point, but there's gonna be an RPG game. I don't really know. I think it's fans versus pros, some stuff about that. We'll just see what happens. Until then, we will go into a small break, like 10 minutes. To refresh a little, to eat something, and I don't know, you can watch some Jera Cup somewhere, I bet. So, yeah, let's see what happens. I'm trying to get some infos from the Chinese organizers, and we'll be back in a second.